The treaty debate was addressed in prayers, sermons, lines from movies and old lines at the dawn service at Waitangi. The Prime Minister copping a bit of flak for reusing parts of last year's speech at yesterday's pōwhiri. Our team's been following events. In a moment, Te Aniwa Huri Hanganui has reaction as a hikoi to defend the treaty arrives at Waitangi. First though, here's Deputy Political Editor Mikey Sherman with how the day got underway.
Thousands braving the early hours to gather at the treaty grounds. The sentiment, it seems, was clear.
This is the kairos moment for our nation, a time when mana is being trampled. It is time to honour the treaty and unequivocally restore its mana.
The Prime Minister prayed for unity.
The body is not made up of one part, but of many.
As for others...
Let us pray for all New Zealand.
Let us increase our trust in one another and our respect and understanding for each other.
What have you both made of it?
Oh, it's been a pretty beautiful experience.
It's nice to be in a space where there is kind of a protest this year, you know, but also this just beautiful togetherness and manaaki.
Many likened the treaty to a union of love.
I love you. I am who I am because of you. You are every reason, every hope, and every dream I have ever had.
Just out of interest, where did that line come from?
It's from The Notebook.
You know what, I don't want the treaty to give me love. I want it to defend my rights and freedoms.
Others simply wanted sausages, the public barbecue, a tradition no longer.
How do you feel about that?
Pretty bummed out.
Christopher Luxon dined out with VIPs instead, avoiding the media and questions over an awkward deja vu, parts of his speech yesterday mirroring last year's.
And we know that they likely had different understandings of what they were doing, and we know that in the years that followed, the promise and the obligations of the treaty were not upheld by the Crown.
And there was more.
And part of the story of modern New Zealand...
And part of the history of modern New Zealand is...
The Prime Minister leaving one minister to make sense of it all.
Oh, well, I'd have to have a look at the copies, but the Prime Minister has a pretty busy schedule and certainly I don't have any visibility over that schedule.
They've arrived here with the same āhua they have in the house where they talk at people, have no respect or regard at all for those that have come here for the kaupapa.
As the waka paddlers prepared to set sail, Shane Jones cruised on in.
Our nation is evolving. It's changing every time a plane load of migrants come to our nation. And we, in terms of Māori leadership, we've got to adapt.
That debate sure to continue as Waitangi Day comes to an end.
So much of that debate, Mikey, centred around Acts Treaty Principles Bill. What's the timeline with that now?
Kia ora tātou I tēnei pō. Well, look, the bill is expected to be introduced into the House in the first half of this year, so expect that debate to only ramp up even more over the coming months. Now, people, they will be ruminating on the conversations and the confrontations that we saw here on the Marae Ātea just yesterday. They will be planning and strategising their next move, and that's not just Māori and the next protest to Parliament or the next legal action. It will also be the political parties of the government and how they continue to face up and battle this ongoing criticism. New Zealand First and ACT, their positions are very clear. They are unrelenting. Christopher Luxon, as the Prime Minister, however, he is tiptoeing his way through this treaty debate. He is not willing to say very much at all, and by not saying much, he does risk feeding into the narrative that the tail really is wagging the dog. That has been a challenge that has been put to Christopher Luxon a number of times at Waitangi this week, and the risk with that is it makes him look weak. This is his first big challenge as Prime Minister.
Kia ora, Mikey, thank you. And thousands of people have taken part in the biggest hikoi Waitangi's seen in years. It marks the 184th anniversary of the signing of Te Tiriti or Waitangi, an agreement that continues to both dominate political controversy and bring people together. Our Māori Affairs correspondent Te Aniwa Huri Hanganui reports.
Meddle with the treaty, they warned.
Hikoi mate!
And we will not stay silent. The people delivering on that promise today with the biggest hikoi to cross the Waitangi Bridge in decades.
What do you think of the government?
What I think of the government, oh gee, real scum.
to me, even Winston, even Shane, they were so gutless in standing up and saying it should never have been tabled in the first place. And this is why we are here.
A 200-kilometre journey from Cape Ranga coming to an end. Dozens even arriving on horseback from as far as Hokianga.
Kia ora.
Kia ora.
With Tamariki leading the way.
How old are you?
8.
And what's your name?
Kiwa.
They're the reason so many people have come.
Because they're our future. And do you want your tamariki to come into this future? Kao. So we got to fight for our people and fight for what's right. Toi tu te tiriti.
What does it mean to have, you know, multiple generations part of this movement?
It's how it should be. It's the responsibility isn't left to our kaumatu and kuia. We've got to get our young people on board.
Their ancestors here too.
This is Kawai Kawiti. He's my father. And this is my mother, Martha Kawiti.
Since 1840, breaches of the treaty have been well documented. Many here say they're tired of waiting for the Crown to uphold its promises.
Now's the time, eh? Now's the time. There's no more time, it's now.
The masses eventually gathering on the treaty grounds where Te Tiriti or Waitangi was signed.
It's about us accepting our responsibility to uphold the mana of our tūpuna. Always has, always will be.
The document forging a partnership that continues to be tested.
We've just seen huge numbers gathering again, Te Aniwa, to defend Te Tiriti or Waitangi. What message does all this send the government?
Well, the message is many Māori care deeply about the direction this government is going in and aren't happy about it. Seeing the mobilisation over the last few days has been quite remarkable. The hikoi today, for example, stretched from the bridge behind me right down to near the end of the shoreline towards Paihia. There are at least 50 people on horses, so many in fact that it was deemed too unsafe for them to cross the bridge. They were actually blocked from entering in the end. What we've seen unfold over the last few days, and even before Christmas last year when Māori took to the streets to protest over this government, shows us how quickly Māori can come together and push back when they feel their rights are being breached. Whether or not we see any more of that will depend on what the government does next.
Tēnā koe, Te Aniwa, thank you very much. Well, from Waitangi to the bottom of Te Waipounamu, the South Island, people have been out and about at events all around the country, as Kate Nicol-Williams reports.
The diversity of Aotearoa on full display. Kiwi setting out to celebrate, no matter the weather.
This is probably one of the windiest days we've had in the 5 years we've been here. But as you can see, people still flock here and still want to go out and take part.
Hands-on learning on offer at Te Puia and Rotorua too. More than 1,000 people attending today's event to learn more about Māori culture. Tent scenes at Waitangi this week. Today replaced with whānau fun.
It's lovely to see all types of people here, many races and faces and even from different places.
For some it was all about the kai.
Muscle fritter and a power fritter all in one. It's yummy.
Māori pride on display around the motu, with councils and local iwi organising community events.
My wife's a Kiwi, so yeah, coming into the country and learning all about that, really interesting for me, and really want to be involved and just be involved with everything.
Others getting up close with our founding document at the National Library. For some, it's the first time they've seen Te Tiriti.
I think times are changing, and for me to be informed, I have to come to these things.
There was a misunderstanding, including the word sovereignty, which there was no translation into Māori.
In the South Island, Ngāi Tahu held commemorations at Te Rau Aroha Marae in Bluff. The event close to one of the locations where the treaty was signed.
It's always a reflection of those that have gone before us and the sacrifices that they made.
This year, the government's change in direction is also on the agenda.
There's real potential that we will move backward. So for Ngāi Tahu whānui and for those attending today, it's about discussing the opportunities and how we can move forward together as a nation.
A day of remembrance and education, however people choose to participate. Kate Nicol-Williams, One News.